And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on for some more competitive metagame challenge. This time we're going to go ahead and play with Gruul Midrange. We didn't do the best with the Teamer Elementals a little bit ago, but I think that was more of us being unfortunate than our deck not working so well. As you saw at the end of that video, we're going to be adding in some Hydroid Crises that will certainly help out the consistency of the deck, because that's what Hydroid Crisis does. But now we're going for a deck that, speaking of consistency, really has that, and just has a good curve. It has nothing fancy, nothing like super, super powerful, you know, like Command the Dreadhorde and Mass Manipulation, you know, like those things that are just really powerful. We don't really have that going on here. We just have a nice, solid deck that's playing efficient creatures and efficient planeswalkers, like very good planeswalkers, and just kind of beat other people down. I could see changing out Growth Chamber Guardian for Thorn Lieutenant. That's something that we're going to be kind of seeing while we play the games. I'm still like, I like Growth Chamber Guardian, but I also like Thorn Lieutenant, and I still kind of wrestle back and forth of like which one to really play. You know, Growth Chamber Guardian, we can put counters on it, of course, with the Domri's Ambush or the Vivian Arcbow Ranger as well. To get some more adapting in and turning it into a 4/4, you know, makes it pretty good with Domri and everything. I don't know. It's a good card that where we don't have like card advantage, it's a card that actually gives us some card advantage. Where if we played Thorn Lieutenant, we just wouldn't have card advantage, kind of thing. So I don't know. And Cinder Vines in the sideboard is of course for Nexus. Is Nexus big enough that we need the four Cinder Vines in the sideboard? Maybe not. Maybe we could take one of those out for some other sideboard option, you know, like maybe get some fries in here or something else. We have Harpooners and Shifting Ceratops basically for mono blue, and you know, maybe mono blue is not big enough that we need all of those. There we go. That's kind of what we have though. Those are like the things that I'm, you know, not so sure about. Like, can like with these seven slots in our sideboard that are pretty narrow, Do we need all of them? You know, I'm kind of preparing for more some tougher matchups, but maybe there's some better things to be doing, some more non-narrow, wide, I guess, wide application sideboard cards. I don't know. I kind of want to fit a third Vivian in here, but that's difficult-ish to do. Maybe the Hellkite should be third Vivian, but I don't know, the two's probably fine. And then, yeah, maybe this should be Thorn Lieutenant. But this is where we're at right now. Let's go ahead and get to it. We got Gruul Midrange. So the competitive metagame challenge is something where if you lose one, you are done. So we can't lose. We got to win. If we win two matches, we will get more than our entry fee back. And, you know, three, we get, you know, our entry fee plus three packs and then so on. And it starts going up a whole lot, and there's a lot of prizes if we get to the 5, 6, 7 win mark, getting 10, 20, 30 packs plus extra gold as well. So that's our goal, to get all the gold. Let's see how we do. We may play a couple of these, you know, if we lose early, we may try 2 to 3 times here. This deck, okay, yeah, that's a question that a lot of people ask. Like, since we have things that give counters, should we be playing Incubation Druid instead of Paradise Druid? But Incubation Druid doesn't work very well with Domri's Ambush, because you want to be able to actually kill stuff with Domri's Ambush. And if you put a counter on Incubation Druid, it's just a 1/3. Whenever you're dealing damage, you're probably not killing stuff. Paradise Druid's a lot better for you there. Also, Paradise Druid having Hexproof with the Domri's Ambush is nice, so they can't respond and break it up with an instant. Besides that, we don't have things that are, like, cost like a ton of mana to try to ramp into. You know, like, if we're playing cards like Krasis, like things that we could use a whole lot of mana, like a big mana sink, then having that extra 2 mana would be more valuable, but we don't, so it's not. And the Paradise Druid is just a pretty decent attacker on its own, especially with, you know, like Domri making it a 3/1 and stuff. And that's what our deck's all about, is just attacking and everything, getting out ahead early and staying ahead and finishing the game off. We're not trying to win a super long game here. I wouldn't. Yeah, you don't have Rekindling Phoenix. I don't think you'd want Nullhide for another option because Nullhide makes it difficult to play like your like all the expensive planeswalkers. I think I would replace it with Ripjaw Raptor or Shifting Ceratops. I think I'd be playing those four drops instead if you don't have Phoenix.
Civilization has crept too far. Tear it down.
You are a mighty
Watch
warrior.
Out. They bite.
I can see.
So they don't get the Oath of Kaya, like, you know, with us not attacking Narset, they don't get the Oath of Kaya trigger. Thanks, I'll have a talk. I'll have a talk with my wild cards.
I can no longer nice. Stand by and
the
watch.
Chicken Sandwich plays both four of Gruul Chamber Guardian and four Thorn Lieutenant, but with no Paradise Druid and no Planeswalkers. No Planeswalkers. All right, we'll hit him for seven. All right, so we bring in Veil of Summa and Daredevil. And what do we cut? We cut Paradise Druid. Ugh. I think I cut Paradise Druid and the Hellkite. I kind of feel like. No, Little Domri. They don't really have the creatures for us to fight. Yeah, let's cut two of the Little Domri, three Druid. Would I rather have the Dinosaur over Druid or Domri? Probably over Domri. Alright, would I rather have Harpooner over Druid? Nah, I think I'd rather have Druid. They could be playing Lyra in the sideboard, though. And Harpooner gives us another card that can deal with Lyra. Right now, I mean, I still have the Ambushes, the Arcbow Rangers, and the Vivian, and the Chandras. Do I need four Ambush? Yeah, Ambush is cool. We could probably go to three. Does a good job taking out the Planeswalkers and stuff, though. We'll go three Ambush, two Paradise. Shifty C. Yeah, I could certainly see them having more creatures this game. We didn't, even though we didn't see a ton of their deck, they could be a hero. It could be Esper Hero. We just had like an awesome start and just kind of ran them over. Hey, no ceilings. There you go. We have Mulligan here. We're doing the competitive metagame challenge today. We'll be doing it some this week. This isn't really ideal. We played three times with the Teemer Elementals. Didn't do the best with that. Honestly, I was pretty disappointed how we did. I think the deck's good. Luck was not on our side at all. And so now we're doing that with Gruul, and you know, spend a couple hours here, you know, maybe playing it a few times here with Gruul, and then we'll have a donation deck to finish today off. So I don't feel like we were winning this game very quickly. And I feel like Direfleet Daredevil will be more useful than playing it real early. I wanted to see if they would use an exile removal spell on the Ceratops.
Let's skip to the good part.
Instead of using exile removal on the Phoenix. But now if they have exile removal, that's bad for me. Y'all probably know the card that I'm talking about. Ooh, they don't have it. Despark. Sorry, that's Despark is the card that I've been was thinking about. I couldn't think of the name for just a second. So yeah, so Despark. Wow, they're just slamming more Teferis down.
Right on schedule. I really should have seen that coming.
Yeah, Ceratops could be really good against Simic Flash. If they're making a couple wolves with the Night Pack Ambusher, the wolves can just, you know, like two wolves can block a Ceratops very easily. That's rude. Oh, I don't know how much I'm supposed to actually play around Settle. Those two hitting are probably going to kill my opponent. Yeah, Veil of Summer is in the deck. Like, they're in the sideboard. We brought him in, didn't draw him, but yeah, we got Veil of Summers. Three of them, to be exact. All right, 1-0. All right, let's draw another land so we can get this Phoenix out here. That'll do.
Panic in the street. I bow to no one.
Boom. All right, and Phoenix. You know, 6 power of them at 13. Just a couple of turns. There we go. There's no fooling around with this deck. No fooling around. So it looks like mono green stuff. I guess we want coils against mono green stuff, I suppose. And maybe another dinosaur, and maybe the Growth Chamber Guardians are out. maybe. Yeah, I like Rekindling Phoenix. I like it as a card. So, I mean, I don't think I'm going to miss Phoenix. Like, I'll be like... Like, you know, it's a card that I'll actively be like, man, and I wish we had Rekindling Phoenix still. But, yeah, I'm glad that Rekindling Phoenix was printed and in standard and everything. And that was a well-designed card. Correct. Chandra, yes, you cannot deal with emblems at all. You can't get rid of emblems. Once you get emblems, they're there for good. I kind of want to just double coil here. Green usually doesn't have, like, they probably have, like, a destroy flyer kind of thing, but they don't really have things to get rid of planeswalkers.
From the smallest ant to the largest hydra, nature is beautiful. Stomping time.
I haven't found 4-mana Vivian that hard to cast, because we... Even though we have the 8 mountains, because we have the 4 Land War Elf, 4 Paradise Druid. Also.
Get him.
All right, we got 4 blockers. It's a pretty good number of blockers. We can take out a Steel Leaf Champion.
It's a strange and magnificent world. The land fights for us.
My, my, how you've grown.
My strength fades.
I think we got this. Pretty sure we got this.
Why I don't like people.
Yeah, no other reason. Just that.
We're fit enough to survive.
I mean, I guess I could have done this first. It doesn't really matter. They're dead because we know they're drawing the Ripjaw Raptor. And the Hellkite's just going to kill them. GG's. It's up 619. All right, 2-0. Let's see if we can get to the third win. You know, we got to two wins last time. Let's see if we can get to this third win. Third win. So this is for 500 gold and two packs. So for 2,500 gold worth of stuff for this game here. It's a pretty big game. Well, we are currently 2-0, so it's doing just fine in the challenge so far. Let's see if we can make it 3. Yeah, I like this Gruul deck a lot. It's not fancy. It's just consistent and it's pretty strong. The Arcbow Ranger and the Big Chandra, both very good cards in the deck. Got to the last 3 cards in the deck with Bellhunt and Teferi versus Red, set up to just win if I dodge one burn spell at 2 life, and they draw Bolt to win. Dang. That's a tough way for metagame challenge to end there. The final prize is 5,000 gold and 30 packs, which is a lot of packs.
Forward to seeing you. Oh, I wish you could see your face while I'm beating you. Getting pushed around.
This is risky. If they kill the Phoenix, then they get to kill Domri. I'm not too worried about them killing the Phoenix, though. Wanted to give them a turn not to have Nissa.
Busting heads is my bread and butter.
That was not really ideal to tap the to auto-tap the other forest. That's not really ideal. I guess it's fine. I think the metagame challenge is once per set, I believe. They're a Nexus deck. All right, well, that means I'm gonna have to change a little bit here. Time to be more aggressive than what we are. What we have been. Hmm. So I can play Nissa and Ambush, but I need to tap the land that I tick up on Nissa to do that.
I will aid you. Harness the elements.
I bow to no one.
Oh, I can't. All right, here we go. Cancel. This means that Domri can die. We're gonna have to kill them. Yeah, the Green Cavalier is awesome.
We will not fail.
So they have
Behold,
seven mana now.
True power.
Ooh.
I will endure.
Well, that now. I didn't. We saw Nexus before. I didn't really take Nexus into consideration of when making that attack. Not leaving something back.
Fight on
doesn't
without
always
me.
Work out how you want.
Ugh. Nexus. So it's basically, do I kill Nissa? Or do I just ignore Nissa and try to kill them? They have four blockers, and I'll have five attackers. All right, we got there. So we didn't really see, mass manipulation, did we? That doesn't mean that they're not going to have it here. So, like, Veil of Summer, of course, is great against mass manipulation. Let's try playing two Veil of Summer, two Lava Coil over Growth Chamber Guardian. I could honestly just see playing Growth Chamber Guardians being better, to be honest. There you go. Oath of Kaia killed a 3-3, then White Cavalier, your Oath of Kaia. To get your own 3-3. There you go. I like it. No Ceratops. While Ceratops is good against manipulation and melody, I don't really think it matches up that well against other green creatures. Cavalier of Thorns is so busted. I think it's a 5-6. It wasn't for Cavalier of Thorns. Well, that card's pretty good too. I think I need to not die to mass manipulation. I think. Surprised they didn't just do 6. I feel like drawing another card and gaining another life, but really just drawing another card would be worth instead of playing the Llanowar Elf, but maybe not.
Some kindling, and you look limp. Let's get toasty. Together, we will prevail.
I was hoping my opponent would have mass manipulation now, you know, that we have the Veil of Summer. I don't want to see all these other just huge threats. Their hand was pretty good.
Someone's getting a little sweaty.
Could have really used drawing a good spell there. I don't think I'm winning this game. Yeah, we get to pick if we want to put it back on top or on bottom. Our opponent did it after our draw step, so like if we put it back on top, you know, like we were not going to be drawn at that turn kind of thing. Amplitory, this is my Gruul list here. Just doesn't even kill anything.
Rise, my elemental friend.
I mean, I don't think we're going to beat a hand, have a hand like that again. Or need them to stumble. I don't really see us beating another hand like that. But just a deck full of, you know, Ripjaw Raptors and Green Cavaliers and Nissas and Krasis, it's hard for us to beat. This is definitely a tough matchup for us. Like their things line up very well defensively. I don't think Daredevil for Aether Gust is really worth it. Yeah, we beat the 5-6 Reach the first game because of Domri's ambush. You know, like Phoenix was a 5-3 because of Domri, and then like the ambush. God, I'm not sure if I need these Veil of Summers. Like, I don't really love Veil of Summer or Coil, but I don't really love Growth Chamber Guardian against a bunch of 4-5s either. I don't really love... don't love my options. I need to curve out. Coil kills their 0-3 mana creature to slow them down. Alright, we got everything except for our top end. We just gotta draw the top end. Like, draw Nissa now. Nissa. Ugh.
For me, it's just another day. Ravnica deserves its demise.
We're six mana Chandra. Or Hellkite.
Seek shelter in my stewardship. The land fights for us.
I'll be back after I've licked my wounds. You'll see.
Not another land. Come on, deck. I can't even kill Nissa. Why does Nissa have to have 6 loyalty? Why can't Nissa just have 5 loyalty? Why can we draw one big spell? Well, I think my best way of winning this is going upstairs and hoping to draw Hellkite. And hoping they don't have Krasis to gain a bunch of life. Kite. Well, now our Hellkite's safe from an Aether Gust, if they have one of those, or whatever that card's called. Hellkite. Spellbreaker. Yeah, Ceratops doesn't do it. Yeah, Ceratops just gets blocked by these lands. Or like they just block with an O3 or just double block with the lands. We need Hellkite or Big Chandra. Arcbow Ranger, okay. Now we're talking. Oh, right, that doesn't counter. Before they're able to minus 8 the Vivian and make the lands indestructible, we're getting rid of a land.
The land will help us find a way.
Yeah, blue lands are these lands are colorless. They don't have any color. These things block Ceratops. Lands are colorless.
I have survived Nico Bolas, and I will survive you.
I must go.
With my aim and their claws, you're done.
It's not ideal.
My, my. How you've...
All right, well, we got one draw step before we die. It has to be our one Hellkite. Oh, I thought that was the Hellkite. Oh, I thought that was Hellkite. Dang. Ugh. Mass Manipulation. That's not a card. Speaking of like cards are gonna miss them or not, I am not gonna ever miss mass Manipulation. Just so, hey, you play this whole long game and hey look, now none of it matters because you just top deck this card that just takes all of yours. Hey, we got a Mythic. We've been opening pretty good packs today. We've gotten a Mythic Wild Card and a Mythic. Very good. Need Mythics for the collections. That's good. All right, we'll play one more of these. So we went 2-1. That was a tough matchup that we almost got there. Came very close. If I just let my Vivian go, that could have cost me if I just like let them Aether Gust the Vivian and don't cast that spell, because you know I had the spell to counter the Mass Manipulation in hand. Yeah, if we didn't use the Veil of Summer. That may have cost me that. I'm not sure. Of course, I wouldn't have had the coil for like that other land at the time. Oh, I thought I was on the play. I kept this thinking that I was going to be on the play and like turn 2 Spellbreaker on the play and just kind of go from there. I'm not sure if I like this as much on the draw, but we'll see. All right, we have 4 power. They have 3 power. They just not have counter spells? Are they just sitting on like spell pierces and negates and stuff? I guess I should target the thing that has hexproof. Enough JG, you're probably good. Like, I don't think Simic Manipulation is probably that bad against the Flash decks. Alright, getting game one's nice. Having all these Veil of Summers, Harpooners, and Ceratops, and Coil. Bringing all those things in. All right, so Nissa gonna come out. Arcbow Ranger kind of wins the game though if it resolves. Kind of the same with these other things, though. I don't know. Domri's plus one, of course, means that like Phoenix and Hellkite aren't getting countered, but... I guess you're just pretty slow, aren't you, even though you can't be countered? Let me just try this. All right. Game number two. I think they're on 6 as well, I believe. Oh, they're on 5? That's rough. Yeah, Cinder Vines are for Nexus. Yep. Come on. Yeah. So honestly, yeah, like that's, of course that's a lot of slots for just one deck with like the Cinder Vines for Nexus. I mean, Cinder Vines can do some other random things against people if you really want, but it's basically just for Nexus. But I just think that's, I think that's a pretty tough matchup for us. And I think that matchup's worth having those slots right now. That's something I talked about at the beginning. I could see changing that, but for now, I'm happy with that. Okay, good job, Matthew. 2-0. Very nice.
I look forward to seeing you. Run. We won't answer to other guilds.
It's double trickster. All right, you got me with the double trickster. That was one trickster.
No, I'm not finished with you. Not by a long shot.
All right, Phoenix is in there. No. Could just ambush a trickster and then, you know, be able to attack in for more, but the tricksters just aren't really that important, I don't believe. All right, so we got lethal in the air if they draw a land. We were, of course, definitely blocking with Harpooner on Trickster there to not let them draw that other card if they would just go to combat first. We were certainly blocking. All right, 1-0 here in this league. Oh, yeah, I guess so. I guess we started a new one. Got to get past two wins, but of course we have to first get to two wins. You know, we got to win this first. That's Mulligan. And we're at five. We will keep the five. So I could get rid of the two. Yeah, I guess we could just get rid of the two removal spells, which is rough. But we just try to have turn three Nissa and just see if that wins. Oh, no. The turn three Nissa plan, not ideal against the red deck that has shock. All right, so we know they have shock in hand, so I'm just going to play the Stomping Ground. Either they have shock or they have it on full control mode. Probably shock. Hopefully no Chain Whirler. They just threw away their shock. Ambush, you know, takes away basically both of their firebrands there. And we see why they threw away their shock.
Oh, I am gonna love tearing this place to the ground. Stomping time.
This is going to be tough to beat Frenzy. We'll see. See how lucky either we or our opponent gets. That was not lucky for a turn one. We obviously need to draw another land. And if we do, I'm probably going... Yeah, I'm going to be going Nissa. Start making a bunch of creatures that all have a lot of power. We did not.
Duels off a personal. Oh, I wish you could see your face when I'm beating you.
This will be fun to watch.
It's a big Paradise Druid. It's a big old Paradise Druid.
You were lucky to get that close.
Our opponent has not been very lucky with Frenzy so far.
Nothing but dust when I'm done.
We're fit enough to survive.
All right, they're down to four. with my 9-7 Paradise Druid. We have this Hellkite that can fly over even if they get like a bunch of blockers or something. That's what we don't want to see. We do not want to see burn spells. We want to see creatures. That is not what we want to see. No. Good. I like land. Maybe another land. Where's my good game? The biggest Paradise Druid. Coming through clutch there. Alright, so against red. Daredevil Coil works. Ceratops just being a 5/4 is decent. Feel like Chandra's too slow. We could, you know, we could play Cindervines here for this matchup to be able to destroy Frenzy, but I don't know if that's really what we want to be doing. Usually I kind of board out Paradise Druid, but the Paradise Druids are pretty sweet. Can I take out Domries? Probably. Like, does this work? This could work. Yeah, your donation deck later, good brother. The Leyline Ascendancy. That's death by mana dorks for sure. You cut the elves. Yeah, definitely see cutting some elves. Just want to try to get to Nissa fast. Hey, there's Nissa. Down to 5 cards, which is not many the last time I checked. Frenzy can still get him out of it, plus my hand's not really that great either. Cool, thanks Zod, yeah. Yeah, if you don't have the Chandra Planeswalker deck yet, you can get it there. Yeah, earlier, yeah, we were 2-0 earlier and then we lost. And so now we started a new one, so we're 1-0 and this is the second time, the second event here with this deck. Be nice to draw something else to play here. I don't really want to play Growth Chamber Guardian and let it die and me not get other Growth Chamber Guardians. But that's what we're doing. It's a little bit of an impatient shock upstairs.
Cannot protect itself. Be wary of the ground you walk on.
Hmm. was rude. So let's go grab another GCG. I think we'll have this. Yeah, 7's a really nice life total to be at.
Behold, nature's true power.
Alright, they're at 4. That should be it. The mulligan to 5. Alright, we're back to 2 wins. We've gotten to 2 wins quite a bit today. We haven't gotten to the 3 wins yet, though. This is the time. Here we go. We're due for the 3rd win here. I don't think you need Fight with Fires for Nyss in the deck. I don't think playing a card that's like a lot better when you have Nyssa in play and a bunch of mana. I don't know, like you're already doing pretty good in those spots. Oh, if I just had speaking of red mana. All right, we're going down to 5. All right, at least we know that our bottom cards, you know, we have 2 basic mountains down at the bottom of the library, which are 2 cards we don't want at all, so that's good news. We want some good news. Yeah, Fight with Fire, yeah. I've been really, really impressed with these Domri's ambushes, actually, so I don't think we really need Fight with Fire. So this is Bant Ramp. Is it just Bant Nexus? Or just, okay, Bant Risen Reef stuff. Pretty good hand, turn 2 Risen Reef. So can one Spellbreaker beat their whole deck that started with turn 2 Risen Reef? Unlikely. Voracious Hydra is a really good card. Again, I think that's for more of a deck that's trying to ramp more than we are. Nyssa is just so strong that we have Nyssa's in there, but besides Nyssa, we're not really ramping in our deck. Yeah, we could have another Hellkite for a Mana Sink, yeah. But that's the thing about our deck. We're not really trying to have Mana Sinks. We're trying to win games quickly. Our cards hit pretty hard, and our Planeswalkers hit hard too. You know, like Vivian putting counters on our stuff. You know, Nyssa obviously making a whole bunch of creatures. Chandra with the emblems. We're trying to like get ahead with these creatures, have the Planeswalkers finish the game, and not really try to go on for a while and sit up board stalls and everything like that. So this is turn 4. So Scapeshift costs 4 mana, so that's a card you should be playing on turn 4, right? I mean, this was like modern level of like 7 mana turn 4 Scapeshift. That's like what you do with like Valakut in modern. It's like, what our opponent's hand here. Why is this Blast Zone untapped? Why did this thing untap? Escape shift puts him onto the battlefield tapped. I don't even understand why that's... Oh, now it's tapped. Okay, now it's tapped and has one counter instead of untapped and two counters like it was a little bit ago. Yeah, that was weird. So we're probably going to need 6-mana Chandra. We need another land, of course. But then 6-mana Chandra can do the wave and kill a bunch of zombies. Hoping they weren't going to attack. Now this is their turn 5. Well, at least we paired our Moldavite against their perfect hand. Turn 1 Grazer, turn 2 Risen Reef, turn 3 Circuitous Route, turn 4 Scapeshift, turn 5 Scapeshift. What else are they doing to win the game besides that? Is that it? The only thing I'm considering taking out Growth Chamber Guardians for something else. Nah. Yeah, they could have mass manipulation, who knows? Well, there we go. We can keep a 7-card hand. Get a good one, too. Ugh, man, this third win has been really tough for us. Yeah, Banned Arcbow is probably still playable. Wow, did they just not play a land? I don't think they did. I haven't been focusing on the deck too much.
This is probably a waste. Killing that thing. Now our Llanowar Elf gets to start doing damage too, though.
Trust me, you'll thank me later.
Don't think I will.
I've got time.
I bow to no one.
You just let me know if you're up for round two.
I think we got this. We're gonna hit him for 9 this turn. Put him down to 9. And we'll have 10 in the air with the two Phoenixes. So if their plan is just like scape shift, make a bunch of 2/2s, like basically if that's their plan, they die. So we'll see if they have a better plan than that. If they had just mass manipulate one Phoenix, we could beat that also. With the help of Domri fight. Alright, can we break serve game 3? I guess they get to gain a lot of life, though. They have all the gain life lands, though. So maybe this isn't over yet. We'll see how many of those life gain lands they're playing. If they're playing, they just have to have 2. Start just taking out 2/2s. Yeah, I've just played against it a few times, T-Zar. It's looked pretty strong playing against it. But yeah, it looks strong.
Oh, I wish you could see your face when I've beaten you.
Meow, 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 meow. All right, can the Phoenixes finish them out? Hope so. Hope we're going to game 3. Like, do I really want Daredevil for, like, down. Daredevil circuitous route? Daredevil That's growth spiral? Like I don't think so. I don't think I really have anything cool to do with Daredevil Escape Shift in here. I'm not playing, you know, like, Omnath. Or anything. Alright. This card is pretty slow here, but these just aren't amazing. Is it weird to take out one GCG? Is that weird? Only play three? I don't think I've ever done that before. What if we do that? And play a Ceratops. Yeah, I would like another Hellkite, and I would like one more Vivian and one more Hellkite. Finding room for them is tough. Honestly, maybe one less Domri for the other Vivian. Kind of talked about that last time. But yeah, I do want one more Vivian, one more Hellkite. Maybe minus one Domri, minus one Chandra. For a Vivian and a Hellkite. Well, this isn't being their best hand like they had game one. Go to the advanced filters and look for a tab that says basic lands. You know, it's next to, like, if you'd filter by commons or uncommons, you can filter by basic lands. And change your basic like that. Maybe they don't have Scape Shift this time. Yeah. Maybe they don't have Scape Shift.
Sorry, I'm late. Let's try this. We will meet again.
Please don't have Scape Shift.
I've survived an apocalypse. I will survive you. Stomping time.
As long as there's no Scape Shift, no Scape Shift. I mean, can they just go one out of the three games of not having it in their hand? That would be really nice. This doesn't look good. Come on. No. Why do they have to have it every single game? Couldn't they just go one game without it? I'm assuming they can only play four. But they just have it, like, immediately, like, best, like, you know, first time possible. Or, you know, first good chance to have it. They have it. Yeah, they drew really well this whole match. Like all three games, their hands were like, you know, top 15-20% that their deck can possibly do every single game. All three of them. Yeah, I mean Chandra. I mean, yeah, if we could, you know, Chandra minus is our sweeper, but we don't have six mana next turn. We have the two win curse. Yeah, Haran, yeah, you did a video of the Goblins deck. You can check it out there on the YouTube. Yeah, that was their turn five. The game one that we lost, they scapeshifted like that on turn four and on turn five. They scapeshifted both turns like that. Yeah, this has been just a really frustrating day. The team are elementals, we just drew like our worst card possible game after game after game, draw step after draw step, over and over. And now that happened. Just keep on getting the two wins, which two wins is profitable, two wins is, you get 2,500 gold worth of value and it's 2,000. But it's just always the two win. We just keep on running into, like, both of those leagues are, after we had two wins, our opponents just had awesome, awesome hands every game. Okay, so that's two. We've done that twice. So do we go over to Leyline Ascendancy now, or should we do, should we run one more here with Gruul Midrange, or we could go one with like Sultai Dreadhorde? So we could try Sultai out. I was kind of planning on doing this deck tomorrow, though. Whatever I feel like. Because, yeah, I want to play the Sultai deck tomorrow, play a little bit longer. Maybe try one more with Gruul. Let's switch. Let's try something with Gruul. Let's take out a Domri, take out a big Chandra, put in another Hellkite, and another Vivian. Yeah, we're gonna be playing this Sultai deck tomorrow, because, you know, I'll be playing more of the competitive metagame challenge and everything. So let's do one more league here. I am going to reset arena. Alright, so we're going back to 0-0. So we'll play one more with Gruul Midrange here, and then we'll go over to Leyline Ascendancy with the donation deck after that. Vivian Arcbow work in this deck? We are playing Vivian Arcbow. Like, which, like the actual artifact Vivian's Arcbow? We probably have too many non-creatures for the artifact Vivian's Arcbow. Are you talking about like Vivian Arcbow Ranger? Yeah, if you're talking about that. All right, let's play one more here. Let's see if we like these changes. Yeah, two's enough. Yeah, we don't really need a lot of Hellkites. I think two's enough. Our deck is about getting ahead and staying ahead, and Hellkite does a good job of that. Never mind, Hellkite's terrible. Let's roll again. I do think that the London Mulligan rule helps this deck. I think as you can see here, like even like the games that we've been mulliganing, we are curving out consistently. I think that like basically decks built like this that are just based around curving out, are like, I think those are the kind of decks that gained the most with London Mulligan rule. I think it's easier to curve out. So I'd rather have Spellbreaker counter than Phoenix, but I'm going with Phoenix here because I only have the one red source. And therefore, if they, you know, get rid of the Paradise Druid, it may be harder to actually cast Phoenix.
If you show remorse, I'll show restraint.
And we have the two Phoenixes.
I've got time.
This is just blue-white.
This is hardly my worst defeat.
It has to be Esper, right? Maybe not. Yeah, we've played against multiple people today that have been playing Absorbs. It's a Bant deck. And this is why we're playing Paradise Druid, not Incubation Druid. You know, Paradise Druid wouldn't kill the 1-3 there. I don't want any of these cards absorbed. Which card am I throwing into a counter spell? I guess Phoenix. No counterspell.
Right on schedule. Don't worry, I got this.
Will not fail. Rise, my elemental friend.
This is hardly my worst defeat.
Very possible that playing the Growth Chamber Guardian here kind of ends up biting me, like where we're not playing it and adapting it immediately. They're like blue-white splash Paradise Druid. Hydroid Crisis.
Fight
Okay, so they'll take a bunch of damage.
I love everything from deer to dinosaurs.
Let's get that thing out of here.
You picked the wrong fight.
All right, game two. Oh yeah, I never updated the stream title, sorry. Now we on Gruul Midrange. I'm trimming a couple Paradise Druids with like the game going longer and taking out a Vivian and a Domri that kind of require us having other things for them to be very good if we're not going to be fighting as much stuff too. But I don't know. They're a Bant. Maybe we are going to be fighting a bunch of stuff. I don't know. But I want the Autumn Veils and the Ceratops in against the Absorb deck, I think. I don't know. We'll see how we do. Yeah, we played Teemer Elementals a little bit ago, Desta, and now we're playing Gruul Midrange. These are the decks we're playing right now for the metagame challenge. We'll be playing Sultai tomorrow. I'm going to be playing the Teemer Elementals again, I guess probably Sunday. Yep. Yeah, you can cast Veil of Summer in response to a counterspell, and then your spell resolves. Because, yep, they counter your thing, and then you say, no, things can't be countered. And then their counterspell resolves, but it sees that things can't be countered, and then it's all sad. Definitely don't like having just a ton of Growth Chamber Guardians, because it just takes the weakness down of the card. They're still like 4/4s, though. So, like, would I mulligan a turn 1 Landwar Elf, a removal spell, and a bunch of 4/4s? I was ready to click mulligan, but that kind of sounds silly now that I say it out loud. I was all ready to mulligan that. Cool, we're gonna need a little bit more land. They're not really 5-mana 4/4s, because you get to play them at turn 2. Like, you know, they do cost 2 mana, but then you have to invest more mana into them. But it's not like you have to wait till turn 5 before you start playing anything. It's much better than that. And we can play him without having to worry about removal spell with us having more of them.
I am not going to sit this one out. Trust me, I have a plan. We will meet again.
Fairy's trying to take Land of Worlds out to lunch, to a deli. Saying, we will meet again. So if we're activating Growth Chamber Guardian, which we are, attack with one of these, activate and still play a 2-drop. Growth Chamber Guardian's a solid 2-drop. You know, it's spend that adapt mana, you get a 4/4. It's very big for a 2-drop, and get to replace itself. You know, drew a card.
This isn't a fight you can win. I'll protect you.
The win con of the Omniscience Flood of Tears deck is, at least the one that we played, the win con was just to Mastermind's Acquisition for, like, for the spell that, or, like, Mastermind's Acquisition for Thousand Year Storm, and then Thousand Year Storm cast Inescapable Blaze.
Only time will tell.
Yeah, so the 87 life didn't matter. Yeah, that wouldn't matter. Hey, Herars. Or Heroers? Maybe that's how you pronounce that. Probably Heroers. Hope you're having a fun van ride. For touring, that sounds pretty sweet. Headbutt. So they've been short on mana. So let's cut them off of mana. Getting rid of that Paradise Druid. I still want to be able to adapt these 2/2s, so that's why I didn't put any counters on these other 2/2s. I still want to be able to adapt them. We'll see if they have a sweeper. Finalia Devastation for 2. They would have Devastation for 3, they could at least get. They could have got the thing that to eat up all my Growth Chamber Guardians. Could have got Deputy Detention. Hey, Royal Flesh. Alright, 1-0. Yeah, I'm doing the. Yep, we're going to do the Leyline Ascendancy donation deck after this here, Elijah. Yep. So we're going to play. This will be our last league here, and then we'll have Leyline Ascendancy. Oh, you're welcome, Azelazel. Glad you're enjoying this Gruul deck also. Yeah, I like it too. It's good quick games and no nonsense here. I like it. Thanks, Pazda. Cool name, Pazda. Am I gonna Domri's Ambush one of these walkers? No, let's get Phoenix out here. Oh, if I was taking more for tonight. Depends on how long this takes. You know, like if we get to like 4, 5, 6 wins, you know, and this takes a while, then I won't have time. But if we like lose this match, then I'll probably have time for one more donation deck. So like, I guess it depends on how long it takes us to lose. All right, let's get one of these out of here before Jade Light Ranger comes down and messes things up.
I can no longer stand by and watch. No, I am not making this up as I go.
Cool. So yeah, just kind of stick around, Elijah. We'll see if we end up having time or not.
That didn't go according to plan.
Could I have Vivian kill another Wild Growth Walker there? Oh, this is a Field of the Dead deck. Oh. We lost to Bant Field of the Dead earlier. Can't say I was really expecting it, to be honest. Wow, that's a great card.
The arcbow at my side, I can't lose a fight. Stomping time.
Yeah, just going with the planeswalkers instead of the green red cavaliers. Really like the, you know, like the planeswalkers are really strong. World Shaper.
This will be fun to watch.
All right, we'll see what they got.
Anyone who stands in my way is getting sizzled. Check out these fireworks.
Right. Those things being elementals always mess me up. Forgot about that. Well, at least they won't be gaining life from those. All right. Yeah. Kind of forgot about that. Because I could have just put the other two counters on the Phoenix and hit them for 8 and then gave them an emblem. And have them at 2 with an emblem. Imagine that would be difficult to come back from. All right, if we take out Growth Chamber Guardians again, because, you know, like how they don't really match it that well against a whole bunch of, like, little 2/2s coming in. And we definitely want Lava Coils for the Wild Growth Walkers. But what's our other card that we're playing? Are we going to Veil of Summer and try to get something there?
My shifting ceratops. Veil of Summer is not great against Little Teferi. Yeah, it's the second time that I've minused and not killed Wild Growths. I remember I did that some other time. I don't remember when, but I know that's the second time I've done that.
I guess Ceratops. This is a good matchup for Chandra. We're not going to take it out because Chandra's like our only, you know, Chandra's our only thing to kill a bunch of zombie tokens. Yeah, I have been remembering that Chandra can't get countered. Like, that's something I learned, that Chandra can't be countered. I don't think I'm going to make that mistake anymore. Learned that one. Still not doing anything till turn three. No blocks. I wonder if my opponent's playing no explore creatures. What if they're just not playing explore creatures?
You think I'm crazy? Busting heads is my bread and butter.
We're gonna need more mana. Dang. Why'd I have to make fun of them? You know, they just didn't do that last turn, so I figured they didn't have a Jade Light. They ripped it off the top, though.
Ooh, right on my noggin. What's that? Something smells rotten. Wait, that might be me.
That was the worst case scenario for us.
Let's slow this down. That's more like it.
This is our second Scapeshift deck to play, and we've played two Esper Control decks so far.
I'm not finished with you. Not by a long shot.
What
did our opponent shock in for last game? Oh, they just shocked in for the Hollow Fountain. For the white mana. So punished for not coiling the Wild Growth Walker. Yeah, we have been playing against a lot of Baby Teferi. So, double explore a creature at the top and then just throw it in the graveyard. Doesn't seem like it makes the most sense.
am gonna love tearing this place to the ground. Stomping time.
Yes, I did. I did put myself lethal to them just attacking out at me anyway. But I felt like that was my best plan of winning the game. Was them getting distracted and attacking Arcbow Ranger and not attacking me. Hey Gustavo, doing good. All right, let's see if we get a lot better hand than that. Okay, it's a good start. Should probably go 4-4 Spellbreaker. Nope. Not with having Vivian back. We can just go 3-3. They're gonna have Counterspell. Not gonna have Counterspell, right? Nah. All right, we got a race. Yeah, whenever the lands are going to rotate out, Apollo, in the fall when we have rotation, there's going to be... You have got to be kidding me. Spell Pierce? You have got to be kidding me. There's going to be new dual lands, basically. People are not going to be playing Gates. Ugh. Wow. Definitely felt this game was in the bag before that spell pierce. It actually randomly has spell pierce in it.
I know my responsibility. Here goes nothing.
You've got to be kidding me. We can't draw a land and play Nissa. Yeah, that's if they win this game, it's all going to be because of that spell pierce. That spell pierce was incredible. That's a pretty big tilt.
Oh, I've done the hero thing before.
Do we get him? Did we get him? I guess they have to have 4 gain life lands. Have to have 4 of the gain 1 life lands. Yeah, they're not going to be able to get 2/2s. Okay, they just got 5 gain 1 life lands. Down to 2.
This might be a bad idea.
I mean, if they have another... if they have another scape shift, we're in trouble.
Sorry, I'm late. Here we go.
So they're going to be playing Scapeshift here. So it's just what's my best plan against it. So they get 7 2/2s. I think I'm supposed to play Phoenix and have a flyer to finish them off. But playing Nissa and Paradise Druid means I definitely get to Chandra next turn.
I bow to no one.
I guess they could. I guess it's possible they have a bunch more gain life lands. Do I even make the attack? Yeah, we can't really wait and give him another turn. Can't really let them have 8 lands and then scape shift. I don't think. I don't know, it's just a whole bunch of more zombies. Yeah, I could wait a turn. I could let them do that next turn. No more life gain. Wow. They let me... Why did they just not block with a whole lot of things? They just let me deal 1 damage. So now Chandra Emblem could kill him. Oh, come on. Don't just gain a bunch of life there.
Let's try this.
All right. Good job, Phoenix.
Oh, that was a stressful one. A game that I thought we had easily in the bag, but that spell pierce on the Vivian, and then suddenly everything changed.
I would have played... Nissa could have got countered where druids wouldn't have. So yeah, I could have just gone the 2 druid to be able to have the Chandra. You can't do minus X to player, so like I couldn't kill my opponent with the minus X ability with the Chandra. You're not allowed to do that. Yeah, this is basically our final boss, huh? This is the level we haven't been able to get past. Alright, let's draw a couple lands. I need one dual land and one forest. We're just trying to get to three wins. That's all we're trying to do. Oh, we need final boss music? Yeah, whenever you lose, you're done. You're eliminated when you lose. Yeah, it's not the final boss, that's true. It's you know, the mid-game boss that we haven't been able to get past. The level that makes you turn down the difficulty. Yeah, this is our last competitive metagame challenge. Yep, and then we'll be doing the Leyline Ascendancy after this one. So it feels like the Vivian's going to get countered if we try to play Vivian, right? Let's not play anything that gets countered. Let's just activate the GCG, draw a card, get a quality hit of six in here. I mean, I don't know. Maybe, like, I would assume my opponent has counter spells, but maybe not. Maybe my assumption was wrong.
Civilization has crept too far. Tear it down. We're gonna tear you apart.
Either way, whether we played Hellkite, Went Haste, or the Vivian, either way, we were putting them down to one. I think it's more likely that they'd have like a Spell Pierce kind of card, something that would get counter the Vivian later, where we could also just play the Hellkite. Why was Hellkite lethal? It's a 4/4 haste. Yeah. So
back to the woods.
Would have put them down to one again. What are they doing here? Can't think of anything in the format that saves our opponent. Rally of Wings. Okay. That was a card in the format I didn't know about. That was not on my radar at all. Did not know that card existed, so now I will. If I knew that card existed, I would have just played Hellkite and put the counter on the Hellkite here. Not try to attack with it. What? They just... Okay, they didn't... Okay. Okay. I was like, what? But that's why. Okay, because then if they drew the... But they had the eagle in hands, they just had lethal. Good block.
Good block.
Alright, let's get a couple harpooners. Some coils. I took out one of the harpooners from the sideboard for the Ceratops right before this, but now I regret doing that. Wish we had more harpooners. I said I don't know. I didn't say there's nothing that saves the opponent. I said I didn't know of anything that did. And I didn't know that card. My deck's not a sweepers deck. I'm not really playing sweepers. I'm not going to play the Lava Coils, actually. Let's see how lucky we get. Could have turn three Nissa. I mean, if my Nissa gets countered, though, it's just so bad for us. All right, got the Aether Gust out of their hand.
hostile. You got it. Oh, there'll be nothing but dust left when I'm done.
So yeah, we'll trade these with the Spectral Sailor. So one card left.
I'll be back after I've licked my wounds. You'll see.
Power surges through these lands. The land shall conquer you.
So now they don't have like those extra two power flyers to like get Safaro in play or anything. I really don't mind that 2-for-2 trade. Spectral Sailor's pretty good too, how it draws cards and everything. We'll trade those two for these two. I know ours cost more mana, but just trading cards and us having Anissa leaves us in a pretty good spot.
Behold, nature's true power.
Doesn't mean that we're going to necessarily win, for sure. Blah. Card's really, really good. Card has just saved them both games. I can't play around it. There's nothing to do to play around. Like, just gotta attack and everything. It's absolutely perfect for this deck, though. Absolutely perfect for the deck.
I can help you no longer.
And not only for the deck, but for the matchup also. Draw some lands. Wouldn't mind us both drawing a land or two here. We certainly have better top decks, but we don't have mana right now. Specifically red mana. We want to draw Vivian. Vivian's our best draw. Well, that was one of their best draws. Looks like they won the top deck war.
I wouldn't necessarily say it's a rough matchup.
We got blown out both games by Rally of Wings, of course. I didn't know that that was a card. I could have played better game one if I knew about that card. Game two, I didn't really have a choice. I played in such a way with how I traded. I mean, obviously, looking back at it, I didn't sequence the best way to win that game, but I sequenced in such a way to just set it up so I had Nissa against their hands, and that ended up being a very bad sequence against Rally of Wings. So like both games I played in such a way where Rally of Wings blew me out really bad. Hey, more mythics. We have done a very good job opening mythics though today. I think we made, by we I mean obviously me, I think I made that blue-white flyer deck look better than what it is. I think I made it look really good. for how I played. You know, obviously with the game one playing into it, and then the game two, I think I should just slam Nissa or play Nissa and then have Domri Spellbreaker or like Domri afterwards, and, you know, actually activate my Growth Chamber Guardian and not throw away the Growth Chamber Guardian into the Spectral Sailor that I knew about. I mean, well, I didn't know about it, but I, once the Domri resolved. And so I let Domri and Growth Chamber Guardian die in the name of just having this Nissa in play that was going to just overwhelm them with 3/3s, but that was a really bad plan against Rally of Wings. So I made their deck look really good. So there we go. Another 2-1. I just can't get to that third level yet, but we'll get there. You know, that's the thing about Magic, though. You're going to lose, and it's okay to lose, but just learning about why you're losing and how you lost and trying to do something about that for the next time, you know, like I think if we, you know, if I play that matchup again, we have like those same cards, I don't think I'll lose those games. But that's what you have to do with Magic is, there's so many cards and everything. There's so many interactions, so many situations that you find yourself in situations like for the first time and everything. Just take your losses and just kind of learn from them and you know, try to recognize those spots of like what's going on, of why you lost and how to improve. It's why people that play like the same deck over and over again, they usually have a lot better results than somebody that plays a whole bunch of decks, because whenever you start playing the same deck over and over again, you start seeing, you know, like you basically get into every single situation that you can, and you find like ways to optimize your deck and like your choices with your deck the best, depending on whatever scenario you find yourself in. As far as the changes that we made to this deck for that last league, how we took out the Chandra, took out a Domri for the Vivian and Hellkite, I think I still like those changes. I think I'm going to do those changes moving forward, I think. I'll continue with that. Sideboard-wise, just like basically the exact same as what we talked about at the very beginning of talking about the deck with the sideboard. We have 7 slots here that are very narrow. And if, you know, especially like with Cinder Vines, and it's very good chance that we need to diversify that sideboard a little bit, especially with the Cinder Vines there. But I don't know exactly what that would look like. So basically the Cinder Vines are almost specifically for Nexus, which I think we can still, like, you know, if you think about like the decks that we were losing to here, we lost to a couple of decks. Our first 2 times playing it, we lost to a couple of decks that just had awesome hands in 2 of the 3 games, or all 3 games for one of them. And, you know, that happens. And I don't think that's really a problem of your sideboard. And then, like, this third loss, I think I made some decisions that could have changed the outcome. Again, that wasn't really the problem with the sideboard. No, there's no temples in the deck, because this deck's just all about curving out, so I don't have any tap lands. It's just all about trying to curve out. No, I don't throw away the Nexus matchup. No, we have all these Cinder Vines that are awesome against Nexus. We have a pretty fast clock, and we also have Chandra that can give them the emblem as well. Or Hellkite that can activate if they're just on the fog plan. No, I don't want to mobilize District. Having Rekindling Phoenix at double red and Vivian Arcbow Ranger at triple green, I don't want any colorless lands in this deck. Let's see. There's other questions. What about Steel Leaf and Ferox instead of the Planeswalkers? The Planeswalkers are a lot stronger. Why not Sarkhan? Don't like Sarkhan that much. I think Sarkhan works really well when you have a lot of like 3-mana planeswalkers, a lot of cheaper planeswalkers. But when you're playing other 5 and 6 and even, you know, I guess 4, but like when you have other expensive planeswalkers, Sarkhan doesn't work as well. The token that Sarkhan makes is not, I don't know, not that great of a stabilizing force, especially with like little Teferi that bounces it very efficiently. There's a lot of shocks in the format, and just having your planeswalker minus down to 2 and make a 4/4 and then they shock your planeswalker. As far as 5-mana goes, I don't think it's a better option than Hellkite or Nissa. I don't think it's better than Monstrosaur either. But I think Sarkhan works a lot better when you're playing Teferis and Narsets and all sorts of 3-mana planeswalkers. And no, again, we're not playing colorless lands in this deck with the double red and triple green. No colorless lands. Yeah, Simic Nexus is probably a good deck for the metagame challenge. Yeah, I don't know why it wouldn't be. It seems like it's probably just fine. All right, so that's Gruul Midrange. We'll wrap it up here. So if you're watching this video later on YouTube, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned some stuff. And this, again, is another pretty solid deck. If you want to take it to the metagame challenge, I like it. How do you deal with dinosaurs? You just fly over the top with Phoenix Hellkite. You know, Domri's Ambush can make these things a little bigger. And then obviously Vivian, very good against like dinosaurs of just like the +1 makes your creatures really big. And yeah, Nissa can make a whole bunch of blockers. I think you're just fine against dinosaurs. Growth Chamber Guardian, I guess last thing, we talked about how maybe Growth Chamber Guardian, maybe Thorn Lieutenant. It was pretty good for us, Growth Chamber Guardian was. I think I liked it more than what Thorn Lieutenants would be doing. So I think I'm still on Growth Chamber Guardian. Yeah, Boros Feather definitely got better with God's Willing, of course. And the Temple too, yeah. All right, so if you're watching a video on YouTube, don't forget to hit the like button. I'd appreciate that, and I'd also appreciate if you subscribe to the channel. But thank you so much for watching Gruul Midrange here in the competitive metagame challenge. And I will see you for another video. Thanks for watching.